Hello, today I'm here with this week's Will I Buy It video. And it doesn't feel like it's so much this week. I don't know if it's me or if it's the makeup world. But I don't think it's as much as last week, but I have some things. And I was thinking about start with two products that I talked about last week. And the first one is Juvia's Place highlighters. They have released yesterday, I think, four new highlighters, loose highlighters. And these highlighters look really good, and the swatches look amazing, but they are all too dark for me. And they have also said that they are going to release lighter shades as well for pale skin. And the other thing that I was talking about last week was LAsplash Classic Horror, and now they have come out with a release date, and it's the 24th of September. Now we can go into this week's things, and I don't know what to start with. We can start with Natasha Denona. I have nothing from Natasha Denona. I don't think I'm ever going to buy anything, because these products are expensive. They are coming back with a palette that they have released before. I don't know if it was a limited edition, but they are coming back with one palette, the Sunset palette, and now I think it's going to be permanent. I'm not going to buy this palette. It cost $129, and that's too much money. I don't think the colors, the shadows can be that good, so I'm not going to pick this up. The other thing is NYX is coming out. I don't know if it's two holiday collection or if it's just one. They are having something in New York with a lot of influencers, and it seems to be glitter palettes and foil creams, glitter set, and new lippies. In Sweden, the things from NYX are coming super, super late. They are coming like a couple of months after they have been released in the US or in the US. So that, I think it's bad. But they are coming with a lot of stuff. Both palettes, lippies, highlighters, and stuff like that. And it's only one thing that I want to pick up, and it seems like they are coming with new lipsticks, bullet lipsticks in suede matte. I love the liquid suede, so these lipsticks, if they are coming to Sweden, I think I will buy them. But that's the only thing I want to buy from all the pictures I've seen. Next up we have Morphe and Jaclyn Hill again. Now they are releasing a brush set with, it should be 24. And these are releasing in 2 days, on Tuesday. And I'm not going to pick this up. I have never tried anything from Morphe. I haven't tried any brushes or any shadows. But it looked like nothing special, and I'm happy with the brushes I already have. So I'm not going to buy these. And then Lime Crime is also coming out with something new again. Now they're coming out with Bushy Brow Stronghold Gel. So it seems like it's just a brush gel. I don't know if they have anything for eyebrows now. I don't have anything for Lime Crime. Oh, it's also a pen. So eyebrow pen and eyebrow gel. I want to try Lime Crime, but I don't know what I want to try from Lime Crime, so maybe I'm gonna try the gel for the eyebrows. And then Farsali, is it called that, are coming out with something new. They have a super popular primer that is expensive, and I don't know if it's that good that people say, but they are coming out with a new. It's a primer and a serum in one, so it seems to be both skincare and makeup. I'm not going to buy this either. I don't think it's worth the money. I don't know if it can be that good, so nothing for me. Doesn't feel like I want to buy anything this week for the news. Okay, so this is a brand I have never heard of before. It's Labelle. It's a UK brand. I don't know if they're called Labelle UK or if they are just Labelle Makeup. It's vegan and cruelty free. No, it's only cruelty free. And they have put up this picture on a little palette, like a small rainbow palette. And I think it's nice, but I got so much colored eyeshadows right now, so I don't think I need it. But I really like that tomato shade, the red one in the middle, in the bottom middle, and the yellow shade as always. But these are all matte shadows, so yeah, if you want to try something new and like this palette, you can get it the last August it will launch. Then another brand with a colorful palette is Bombshell Lashes. I think they have been before, but now it's Bombshell Cosmetics. They are releasing a limited edition eyeshadow that is called Candylicious. It's 6 shimmers and 12 matte. It's 100% vegan and cruelty free. Then Tarte is releasing, I don't know if it's their holiday collection, but they are coming with a blush book 4. And in Sweden it's hard to get a hold of Tarte because you have to order it from the US, and both the shipping and the taxes, it's going to be a lot of money. So, and it doesn't seem like anything I don't have, and I don't know if Tarte is really that good. So they're releasing this blush book, and they're also releasing an eyeshadow palette that is the shape of a pineapple. I think it's fun, but I don't know how you can store this. It's a boring palette. If I would do a makeup palette that looks like a pineapple, I almost said ananas, like a pineapple and a gold pineapple, I think I would take pineapple-y colors, like maybe green and yellow, and then pop in some gold. But this seems like a normal palette in just a pineapple shape. What do we have more? Too Faced has sneaked peeked their holiday palette. I got nothing from Too Faced, I think. Yeah, I have a mascara from Too Faced. Nothing more. I think they are pricey for boring palettes, and all their palettes smells like either chocolate or peach, or I think Tutti Frutti is going to smell Tutti Frutti, and the 20 years celebration palette, it smells birthday cake, I think. I don't mind smelly makeup, but I don't understand why, and I wonder what this is going to smell. But this is a full face makeup eyeshadow palette with 32 shades. And then it's going to be a limited edition makeup bag with swan prints, an ultra blush lip gloss, and a hangover spray. And if I get a feeling with Too Faced when they're releasing their holiday collections and stuff like that, they take their normal things and just call it a holiday collection and put it in other packaging. A Swedish indie brand that is, I think they're 100% vegan and cruelty free, is releasing, I think they already have released it, a new eyeshadow palette. It's Nevin Cosmetics. I think they are located in Gothenburg. And this palette looks really nice, and lots of people that I follow have received this palette in PR. and it seems like a nice palette. I really want to try Nevin Cosmetics. Maybe not this one, but I want to try their makeup. So maybe I will pick this up. I don't really know. Another brand that is releasing, I think, completely new products is Essence. I have never tried Essence, but I know a lot of people like their bronzer and blush, at least bronzers, and they are releasing foundation in the, this is in German, they are releasing primer, instant perfect liquid makeup, so I don't know if it's, I don't really know what it is. Okay, primer, healthy glow, camouflage and conceal. I don't know if they have had these kind of products before, because I don't know much about Essence. I don't know if I'm going to pick some of these up. I need to see a little bit of reviews and stuff like that. But if they seem to be good and I want to try Essence sometimes, I maybe pick some of these up. Okay, one of the last two things I want to talk about is Chanel. They are releasing a makeup line for male, for guys. I don't know what is Chanel, Boy de Chanel. And I don't understand why. Makeup is for everybody, makeup doesn't have a gender. You can use what kind of makeup you want. So I don't understand this line at all. I don't understand how they now can think this is a good idea. And of course everything is in black packaging. I don't know, maybe Chanel always is in black. And I don't understand what Chanel is thinking. Why should this be a good idea? So Chanel, shape up. Please. Okay, so the last thing I want to talk about is not a new makeup release. It's a makeup product that is going to be discontinued, and that is Urban Decay Naked 1, the OG Naked palette, the palette that changed the makeup world. Urban Decay is discontinuing this, and I don't have it, I don't want it, but I know it changed the makeup world when it came out. Very many people have it, and they are doing a very big thing about this. They had made a campaign with where they had a funeral for the palette, and I think the palette was half off in Sephora and at Urban Decay's own website. Here in Sweden it has not been sold. I think it sold out, but there was no discount on it. A little boring. So that is going to rest. That palette is going to die, if you want to be that dramatic. But I have heard a lot of influencers and beauty gurus and beauty YouTubers that think that it's going to come back. They're going to remodeling it. So they do a very big thing that it's going to die. They had a funeral for it and everybody wanted to buy it again. And so it sold out, and people think they're going to rebrand it, not rebrand it, remake it, and do a new Naked One palette. And I totally get it. I think it's like that too, because now everybody's talking about the Naked palette again. And if they're coming with a new Naked palette, now is really the time for it. So I think they're going to do that. So this was all the products I was going to talk about today. I really hope you liked this video. So please give it a thumbs up. And also subscribe to my channel. So I will see you in the next video. Bye!